There's a website I get obsessed with sometimes. It's called This Person Does Not Exist. The website is hooked up to an artificial intelligence framework that has been trained on thousands, maybe millions of real pictures, and it does one thing. Every time you refresh the page, it creates a photograph of a person that doesn't exist. Every photograph that comes from this website is created ex nihilo from the mind of a machine, and the photographs are very, very convincing. Usually, I come to This Person Does Not Exist to obtain a photo for creating an anonymous account somewhere or to get placeholder photos for projects at work. And every time I come, I get sucked in and I spend long stretches of time clicking refresh, over and over and over and over. Of course, there's something eerie about the fact that a computer program can generate photographs of fake people with such incredible accuracy. And of course, this has horrific implications for the future of fake news and conspiratorial thinking. But that's not what I'm obsessed with. Instead, I'm obsessed with the idea that there's something of a contradiction in the name of the website. Because every time I refresh the page, I'm confronted with a person who does now exist, even if only for a moment. Some of them are smiling, and you can tell this picture was taken by a friend or a family member at an occasion that they're happy to be at. And some are pensive, unsure, even unhappy? I know the website claims these photos are being generated by an artificial intelligence and glitches in the backgrounds as well as the presence of nightmarish flesh beasts on the margins would seem to back that up. And yet, I look into their eyes and I recognize humanity. I recognize life. In a previous career, I was present for many deaths, young and old, timely and untimely, violent and peaceful. I know what it looks like to stare into the eyes of someone who is no longer present. These photos are of people who are, if only for a moment, here. Every time I visit this site, I go into this existential tailspin. How can faces that tell stories only exist because the random mechanics of some computer program flipped 10,000 coins to create this one spark for this 1 second? The occult part of me is terrified that these are somehow real souls that I'm trapping briefly, or perhaps rescuing briefly. Think of every soldier that died in every skirmish between two long-forgotten nations, every indigenous person that succumbed to the diseases of colonialism, every vulnerable life cut short by bad luck. If the dice had broken a different way, they'd have lived and had kids who fell in love with other people's kids and started families, just like the people that started your own family. Is this what the great-great-great-grandchildren of the unlucky would have looked like? Am I, for just a moment, resurrecting one of the world's obliterated bloodlines? I mean, probably not. Intellectually, I know that a network of algorithms is just taking input and regurgitating output in ways it's been programmed to favor. And yet, when I look into their eyes, I recognize humanity. I recognize life. I recognize my people. How can I not refresh the page and give life to someone else that doesn't exist? How can I deny them a taste of recognition and respect? Maybe this sounds absolutely bizarre to you, but think of it this way. Are you and I not both the product of random chance coming out of a system we can barely understand? If the dice had broken a different way, we'd be replaced by people that look a little bit like us, but have different personalities, different talents, different loves. If your parents had ordered the chicken instead of the steak on the night you were conceived, you wouldn't exist. Every time I refresh this website, I see the faces of people whose parents ordered the chicken instead of the steak. I see the people who would exist if I didn't. Do I owe them something? Is existence categorically superior to non-existence? Or perhaps, is their non-existence an injury caused by my own existence? Am I out of my fucking mind right now? I don't know the answer to these questions. I guess I've been thinking a lot about death lately and what comes after. I used to be religious. I used to have a nice story about the afterlife, but those days are long past. As far as I know now, once the spark leaves your body, your subjectivity ends forever. This is almost literally an unthinkable thought. I mean, how can you imagine the sensations and perceptions of something that cannot sense or perceive anymore? I suppose in one sense it's merciful to think that no matter what pain and fear and sadness we knew in life, it can't follow us past that final threshold. On the other hand, I've had a life full of joy, awe, love, and laughter. So many people never had the chance to have what I have. If this life is all there is, I have sampled the best of it. I've enjoyed its fruits, and I've savored every drop. I want everyone to have it as good as I've had it. I think these images of people who never were activate a weird part of my empathy and conjure thoughts of all the people who once were. What's the difference between an AI-generated image of a smiling person and the image of a different smiling stranger on an obituary page? I didn't know either of them, but I have this sense that they mattered. Someone loved them. Someone misses them. They've left a hole. For some reason, these fictitious creations leave little holes in me. Maybe because deep down I just can't feel comfortable dividing the world into people who are real and people who aren't, people who matter and people who don't. Maybe I'm just afraid I already let the pictures of flesh and blood humans who died from war or famine or lack of healthcare wash over me. As if they were content generated by a computer. Refresh the news page and another stranger will appear, banishing the last one to the outer darkness. Maybe it's just safer to err on the side of empathy when a human face stares back at you.